Hey everyone, my name is Kumo and this is my reaction to the 12th and final episode of Isekai wa Smartphone to Tomone. So, last time, apparently Francesca was only walking around without a skirt as a test of sorts from the professor who made her, as a way of seeing if somebody is worthy to, I guess, inherit all of her stuff. And I don't know, it was a bit weird. I mean, at least I gave a reason for that, I guess. That's something. But yeah, everybody else managed to get to the Flying Garden thanks to Toya's gate magic, which his gate magic is really the MVP of this series if you think about it. Well, I guess it has some competition with the slipping magic, but that's, I digress. Not much really happened in the episode. It was mostly just walking around the garden, learning a little bit about that whole situation. But the big thing that happened in the episode, well, I guess there were two big things that were kind of similar, was Francesca doing registration with Toya, which, you know, when that scene was happening and she was going in for the kiss, I thought we were going to get like a fake out kind of deal, like maybe just a kiss on the forehead or forehead to forehead contact or something like that, but no. She straight up kissed him on the lips with plenty of tongue action, and he even had that saliva trail when they were separating and everything. Like, wow. Definitely caught me off guard a little bit, but what was even more shocking than that was Linze took this opportunity to confess to Toya and also kiss him on the lips. I don't think there was any tongue action there. I'd be pretty surprised if there was. I mean, even if there wasn't, that was still probably one of the most shocking things of the entire series. Because this isn't really the kind of series where you expect a harem member, especially one of the more passive ones like her. I don't know. Would you call her passive? I don't know. But and it was very surprising to see that kind of, you know, one of the harem members taking action like that. But, yeah. I think that's all I really had to say, so let's get into the next episode. As usual, there will be no audio or footage of the anime used in the reaction for copyright reasons. There's a timer in the upper left-hand corner, and subs below me to help you follow along. So, let us begin in 3, 2, 1, play. Back at the mansion? That she apparently came to. I guess he does like bringing girls home and having them work for him. What was with the hand motions? Francesca. It's not cute when an old man does it. Yeah, I'm sure he has a lot on his mind right now. Must be a lot for a dense man to deal with. He's worried someone's gonna kiss him again. I bet you that's what he's worried about. So we do get an opening. I swear more than half the shows that have ended so far didn't have openings in the last episode. I just watched New Game, which didn't. Because it is that time of the season when shows just start ending one after the other. Which is always sad, and you always have to kind of fill the, like, empty gap with new shows that come out in the next season. Which, you know, are never as good as the ones you just watched. You know, until you get into them. Then the cycle repeats. Yeah, we did find out that there were other, I think, floating things. I don't know if they were all gardens. No, one of them was the library, I think. So, I don't know. If there was a second season of this, I guess it might focus on that. Him finding the various ones. I mean, would you call them flying fortresses? I'm not exactly sure what you would call them. I guess just floating buildings. Yeah. Yeah, she is her fiance after all. Yeah, she was already well aware that they all liked him. Only he didn't pick up on that. That's a real wife right there. In fact, I'd say Yumina's too good for him, to be honest. Well, the registration was kind of necessary, so I wouldn't chastise him for that one. And with Linza, he was probably still pretty shooken up. Hey man, that's a great deal. I would jump on that. If you don't want to do it, I will gladly take your place. So awkward. Is he really gonna do it? Oh, he did. I thought we were gonna get an interruption. That is something. The show actually has managed to impress me a little bit here and there. Yumina is the best girl in this series, so I don't see what the problem is. Oh, wow. Yeah, obviously, when Yumina did. I mean, to be fair, you probably should have waited for an answer before kissing him, but. But at the same time, kissing him does kind of tell him that you were serious. This talk does remind me a little bit of Tolovru. How could you say no to that? There you go. Yeah, both of them. I mean, you've kissed them both on the lips before, I'm not sure why, but whatever. Oh, wow. That was not a thing I expected. The unexpected romance. I think she wants her kiss. I can almost guarantee that's what she wants. Yai and her probably both want their kiss now. If he does end up kissing every member of his harem in this episode, I might bump this up a point in my score. Yeah, I was about to say, she can't be that timid if she went that far. Okay, a fight rather than a kiss. Okay, that's gonna be the kiss, so we're gonna get both probably. Because they can't just come out and say they want to kiss you too. Forgot he had that gunblade thing. It's still a 2-on-1 fight. Not exactly fair. Even if one of them is practically a god. Oh, she confessed on behalf of Yai as well. Oh, so she did hit her target. Just come out with it. If he wasn't so dense, they wouldn't need to say it. Yes. Yeah, we saw a flashback of that. She's amazing. This is the last episode, and we're almost halfway through it. You don't have a lot of time. I know, right? That's up for them to decide, not you. Yes. I assume that's gonna plug into his smartphone. Cause I'm pretty sure that plugs into a USB port, I think. I don't know, looks, I don't know. Either USB or HDMI, one of the two. Not how I pictured her looking. She is pretty good. Those are quite bold. Oh, I bet you have some big issues right now. Everything. Yeah, in fact, they made an anime about it. Yeah, I was pretty sure she wouldn't tell him. I doubt that. I disagree. Imagine what it'd be like without the leaves covering the important bits. I didn't know we could use Gay to return to God. Watching himself on TV. Or is the reflection one of the two? And didn't, yeah. I like how he gives Toei a magical smartphone, and yet he has that really old school one. Who is that? Oh, wow. Indeed. Important jobs indeed. Well, that's a death flag. I know, right? What exactly is the problem? There is only one way to find out. So she's the one that's responsible for these situations in all these anime. All four at once. He said it. I don't see that happening. Season two and never. He already kissed half of you. Phrasing, but yes. Yeah, you probably should have started with the eye. Oh, wow. That's a lot more hair, I remember. I assume Lean is one of them. Of course, I might have just shown them all right there. So the harem is most likely not complete yet. But still, he did straight up say he would marry all four of them, so. I do give him props for that. Even though he never ended up giving the other two their kiss, but oh well. He kissed Yumina, who is still my favorite. You know, that little eye catch where the stuffed bear and the tiger were kissing, that was hilarious. Who is he talking to on that phone? That was never answered in the series. Yeah, he was in the opening, wasn't he? I don't think he really had any screen time. Whoever that is. I mean, I don't think we've seen him. And, well, if there's a second season, he's probably going to be an important character in it. At least the impression I got. Anyway, that was the 12th and final episode of Isekai wa Smartphone to Tomoni. And, yeah, this has been quite a series. See, what can I. Well, first I should talk about the episode itself. Definitely an interesting episode. I mean, it was definitely an episode focused on his harem and how he feels about them. And in the end, we established that he does like all four of them. And although he's not going to marry any of them right away, he does intend to marry all four of them. Which is definitely more than I expected from him when I first went into this series. I mean, he definitely took time to, mull over it, but he did come to the right decision in the end, even though I am a little bit disappointed that he didn't end up actually kissing all of them, because that would have been great. But I guess half, even if one of them was her kissing him, he still kissed half of them, technically. But, yeah. This is my thoughts on the series overall. I mean, it's a very generic series in a lot of ways. Toya doesn't really have much of a personality, besides the typical whole, nice guy thing. Like, I'm a super nice guy that's overpowered and all the girls like me. Kind of deal. Of course, having a smartphone is definitely an interesting twist as far as, special powers go. And his ability to pretty much learn all magic, which came in handy countless times, as he healed people that were about to die. I think he even cured blindness at some point. Making connections with royal family members and all that. Really making his progress in that new world. But, yeah. I mean, as far as criticisms go, I mean, the only harem members that I really cared for was probably Yumina and Yai. The twin sisters were kind of meh. I didn't really care for them. Especially the one that was kind of a violent tsundere type, which are the type I never really liked that much. But the series definitely had stuff that I liked in it. Like some of the funny little eye catches that I have, like the one in this episode with the tiger and the stuffed animal kissing. Like, they had a lot of those here and there in the series, and most of them are pretty funny. And of course, it had a pretty great beach episode. Can't forget about that. But, yeah. I think that's all I really had to say on this series. It was definitely enjoyable enough to where if there is a second season, I will watch it. But yeah, if I had to give it a score, it'd probably be a 7 out of 10. Through most of the series, I thought it would be a 6 out of 10, but it did end up being enjoyable enough for me to bump it up to a 7 out of 10. But yeah, I think that's all I really had to say, so let me know what you thought of the anime. What you thought of my reaction in the comment section below. Hit the like button if you liked it, subscribe if you want to see more, and I will see you in the next one. Have a good one.